By the anointing, Jesus broke the yoke. By the Holy Ghost and power, just as the prophets have said, this is the day of lettering. Holy Ghost power is moving again. By the anointing, Jesus prayed. It's not by might.
Be on your feet, church.
It's not by power.
It's not by might. By the Spirit.
We say it's not by might. With that song and begin to say, Lord, this mountain must be moved today. Lord, this mountain must be moved today. I have come into your presence. I have come into your sanctuary. I have stepped into your tabernacle. Lord, this mountain must be moved today. It's not by might or by power. Lord, it's by your Spirit, says the Lord. This mountain must be moved today. In that beautiful prayer right now. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. I don't know the mountain you put to the Lord this hour. I don't know that mountain that has stood strong for many years. I don't know how many weeks or months or years they've been there. But today we are commanding this mountain must be moved. Yes, my Father and my God, this mountain, oh God. Every mother in the house this morning, Lord, we take authority over them right now. We take authority over them right now to begin to move right now. Yes, Lord. 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 Father, we thank you. Father, we bless your name. Ancient of Days, we bless your name. Behold your children. Behold your church. Behold your people who you have called from different places, oh God. Father, we have come this hour to surrender all to you. All we have is what you gave. All we are is what you've made. We've come back to you to say, Lord, this mountain, that mountain, which mountain, whatever it may be, this hour, oh God, let them begin to move right now. Let them begin to move right now. Father, have your way. Holy Ghost, have your way. From the church here to those watching online, the Spirit of the Lord will touch you in this hour. For in Jesus' mighty name, we are prayed. Have your seat very quickly and welcome someone by your left, by your right. If you are watching at home, touch someone that is sitting close to you. And so you're welcome to church. You're welcome to church. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Are you excited? Are you prepared? It's a privilege to stand before us once again as we journey in this month that the Lord has given us a theme of victory. A theme of victory. This month we are looking at a very important topic, mountain be moved. Can we say it together? Say it as if you are talking to something. Say it once again. Zechariah chapter 4, verse 6 and 7. Verse 6 and 7. Technical, please, you need to be a bit fast. This is the word of the Lord to Zerubbabel. He says, not by might, nor by power, but by my spirit, says the Lord of hosts. Who are you, O great mountain, before Zerubbabel? You shall become a plain and shall bring forth the capstone with shout of grace, grace to it. Now, when you read verse 7, it talks about who. And who, we know, is a pronoun of person. Talking about a person. Hallelujah. A system. A principality. An institution. He said, who are thou, O great mountain? Now, this morning I want to talk to us on the topic, the secret to moving every mountain. Now, mountains don't just appear. Mountains grow. They start from a small drop, becomes a molehill. There are structures. There are things that cause mountain to become a mountain, some to become a mountain over time. Mountains take generations to become what it is. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So when you are dealing with mountain, you can understand that you are dealing with something that started even before you were born. Even before you began to understand who you are, there are things that have happened that people that came before you have tried to deal with, and they could not deal with it. And it continues to grow. Praise the Lord. So when you read the book of Zechariah chapter 4, and you go to verse 6 and 7, you must pause to understand what is God saying here. What is God showing Zechariah? And when you ask that question, you now begin to know that there is something that the Bible talked about in verse 7. It talks about a capstone. Hallelujah. It says, verse 7, yes, it talks about a capstone. And this capstone means something to God. This scripture is talking about the stone that was laid by Solomon, which was used as the foundation of the temple of God, which Nebuchadnezzar destroyed in the rule of Babylon. And that capstone was buried in the heap of rubble. Praise the Lord. It was buried in the heap of rubble. So at this time, God was saying to the children of Israel, go and rebuild the house of God. But for you to rebuild the house of God, you must find a capstone that was laid before you were born. That is something buried under the heap, under the rubble, that you must get to know that this is the place. Because King Cyrus that gave the order to rebuild said that house of God must be built in the same place. He said, not at any other location. He said, it must be built in that same location. When you read the book of Ezra chapter 4 and 5, you will see that it must be built in that same location. Hallelujah. So, there is something that is called the capstone of your life. So, the first thing you must understand as a secret to moving your mountain is that every mountain has a name. Number one, you must know the name of the mountain you want to move. In the book of Mark, chapter 9, verse 18, a man came to Jesus and was telling Jesus that he has a son who, when he seizes him, he throws him to the ground, he foams at the mouth, gnashes his teeth, and become rigid. The man was describing the symptoms of convulsion. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But in verse 25, when Jesus was about to heal this boy, Jesus was talking about the spirit of deaf and dumb, not convulsion. That is the name behind what the man, the boy was going through. In Mark 5, chapter 9, Jesus came to the man of Gadarene. And the Bible says that this man was known as a madman of Gadarene. They knew him as a madman. But when Jesus appeared, he said, "What is your name?" The spirit behind the problem has a name. The mountain has a name. Praise the Lord. He said, "My name is Legion." Everybody knows him as a madman, but there is a mountain in him that has a name. If you want to cure madness, you cannot go anywhere. If you say madness, go. I'm not listening to you. Because the name is not madness. The name is Legion. Every mountain has a name. Praise the Lord. And because these mountains, the foundation was laid before you were born, you must dig deep. You must dig deep to understand what is behind it. Because mountains are built by spirits. They are not built by individuals or physical hands. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The manifestation of the problem is not the problem. You might have fever, but it's not fever that is your problem. Stomach ache is not the problem. There is a name behind it. The first secret is to understand, what is the name of the mountain you want to move? Do you know the name? Do you know the name? Hallelujah. 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 As what the Lord said, it's not by might. It's not by power. It's by the what? The Spirit. The Spirit must search the place to reveal what is going on. Now, you might have in a family, you see, suddenly, a boy that was doing very well, you know, suddenly the boy just snaps and start misbehaving. You talk, it's not happening. You say, "Oh, this boy used to be a good boy, used to be..." Oh, check back. Hallelujah. Check back. Check back. There are times and seasons of life that a family gets to, the men in that family begins to miss their way. There is a name behind that behavior. Hallelujah. You see a situation where you are married to a man and your problem is that the man, you think that the man is your problem. But when you look into the lineage of that family, the great-grandmother divorced, the grandmother divorced, the mother divorced, the father divorced, and you are still not, that is a name to that problem. It's not divorce. It is shame. Hallelujah. It is shame. If you try to fight it, if you try to go by the flesh and say, "I have my," you will miss it. Every mountain has a name. Has a name. And that is why the first thing you must ask this morning, what is your name, O you mountain? What is your name, O you mountain? You must ask that question in your spirit. This thing you are facing, what is your name, O you mountain? You may say, "Okay, I don't stay in job. You know, I get a job every 3 months. I'm asked to go." It is not sack that you are seeing that is a name behind it. You start a business and every 3 years, 4 years, it collapses. It is not the collapse. There is a name behind it. And when you look into your family, no man has been able to run a business and finish it. It all collapsed. There is a name behind it. is by my spirit. This way, you're going to ask yourself, mountain, what is your name? You must speak. Hallelujah. The mountain said, my name is Legion. Do you understand the name of the mountain you're facing? Do you understand it? Or are you just copying things? You must understand. Everybody has a name attached to what you're fighting. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Secret number two. Secret number two. In every mountain is a trapped treasure. In every mountain is a hidden life. In every mountain, there is something hidden in it, an inheritance trapped in it. And so, when you want to move a mountain, you must face that mountain because in it is the treasure of your life. You don't turn your back to mountains. Don't turn your back to mountains. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Don't turn your back to mountains. That is why when you read the book of Ezra, chapter 4, verse 4, the Bible says that the children of Israel, as they were building the house of God, there were people who stood to discourage them. Who are these people? They were brothers, the Benjamites and Judah. Hallelujah. These two people are brothers of Israel. And the same people that the Bible says that they gathered the people of the land and they hired counselors to frustrate their purpose. In verse 5, he said, they hired counselors to do what? To frustrate their purpose. And all the days of Cyrus, king of Persia, even until the reign of Darius the king, that house was not finished. Cyrus, the king of Persia, gave the order that the house of God should be built, but he lived and died. That house was not finished. Why? Because brothers of the same of the same family stood against them. But they never ran away from that site. They never gave up from that site. They stood on that ground. Though the man that gave the order is dead, we will stand on this ground. We will face this mountain. We will not turn our back until we finish this house. You don't turn your back on your mountain. You don't leave it for tomorrow. You don't leave it for next tomorrow. You face it head on. That is why it is called a mountain. Mountains don't fear you. They don't fear you when you turn your back on them. It is when they know that you are not about to give up. Then they begin to ask questions. Are we sure we are going to survive this man and this sister? Let me tell you, if you study this scripture very, very well, time will fail me. You will understand that the people, the mountain you're facing, may be people that are very, very close to you. People that are even, people that you feed. People that you share the same name with. People that you share the same clothes with. People that you borrowed your shoe, you borrowed your clothes, that took your something. Those are people that you are facing. They'll become mountain to you because of what? There is something about you which makes them uncomfortable. You stood by the place of God. You have followed the Almighty God and unhappy with you. When Israel came back and said, we have come to rebuild the house of God, Judah and Benjamin, they said, no, you cannot build the house of God, and they gathered people against them. They went up and hired enemies to come and stop Israel for being house of God. But they faced the mountain. They never give up. Your mountain will not go if you turn your back on it. The mountain will not leave if you turn your back on it. Listen to me. God is able to move your mountain if you can face that mountain. Your marriage is not working. Face it. Divorce is not the solution. So people think that next marriage will work. It's not going to work. It's a mountain. Hallelujah. It's a mountain. And the Lord is saying to us, when you face opposition, when you face discouragement, when you face frustration, do not give up. There is something about it. It's a treasure. There's something hidden in that mountain that the Lord is saying to you. Hold on. When you face your mountain, there are spiritual petitions that may come against you. You know, the Bible said that Governor Ahasuerus of Judah, he wrote a petition against the children of Israel. Spiritual petition against them. In verse 15, he said, these people, when they build this house, They will not pay tax to you. They will not pay tax to you. Listen to me. When you want to return the glory of your father's house, there will be spiritual pressure that will breathe against you. People that fought you, people that thought there would be nobody left in your father's house, they will go to places and say, the son of that man is back. The son of that woman is back. She is back now to come and rebuild this place. They will rise up against you. Listen to me today. Anyone rising up against you, anyone lift their voice against you, the armor of God will locate them in the mighty name of Jesus. Do not look back. Number three, take the mountain to higher mountain. Step number three, take mountain to higher mountain. There are mountains, but there are mountains. Hallelujah. Micah chapter 4, verse 1. Micah 4, verse 1. Now the Bible says, and now it shall come to pass in the latter days that the mountain of the Lord's house shall be established on top of the mountains. There are mountains, but there is a mountain of the Lord that is established on top of the mountain. When you face mountain, you have to take that mountain to a higher mountain. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It is mountain that swallows mountain. When a bigger mountain appears, that smaller mountain will hide, to disappear. That is why when the Lord sent Moses to Egypt, he said, when you get to Egypt, drop your staff on the ground. Because there is a man in Egypt called snakes. They worship snakes. Their God is snakes. Their power is the snakes. He said, when you drop your staff, something will happen. Something will happen. Pharaoh will do the same. But your serpent will swallow every serpent in that place. And that was how the mountain of God swallowed every mountain in Egypt. Take the mountain that you are carrying to the mountain of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. When you're facing mountain, God is inviting you to a higher mountain. God is saying, come up. God is saying, come up. For 40 years, Moses wandered away from the mountain called Pharaoh. But one day, he came to the mountain of God called Horeb. And that day, he encountered power to overcome the mountain called Pharaoh. That is a higher mountain. And God is saying to you, every mountain you carry, every mountain that is troubling you, every mountain that has become an obstacle, he said, bring it to me. Bring it to me. Bring it to me. Bring it to me. Come to me, all ye that are burdened and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. What is that mountain? What is that mountain? Let us be on our feet. Let us be on our feet. Let us be on our feet. Take it to the Lord. Take it to the Lord. When you face a mountain that is higher than you, the Lord is saying, come to me. There is a higher mountain that swallows every mountain. As we begin to pray right now, you begin to ask the Lord, Father, what is the name of this mountain? What is the name of this mountain, oh God? Lord, I'm bringing it to you right now. In the name of Jesus, what is the name of this mountain? You must search the spirit. You must search the spirit. You must search the depth of the waters to understand the name of the mountain that you're dealing with. I begin to say, my Father and my God, Lord, I begin to pray right now. Every mountain I'm facing, what is the name of this mountain? Begin to pray. Lord, I bring it to you. Lord, I bring it to you right now. Makato legede mazo katalaba. Le brazegede maruse katal. Le kateba upon the mind of the Lord, there shall be established a higher mountain. Be to plan, say, my Father and my God, I bring to you this mountain, O God. Lord, let your mountain swallow them now. In the name of God, to pray right now. Makuta lega de marusi kata. Lekete katu lebrozege de lese kata masu katana. Rekete lega de marusi kata. Begin to plan, say, my Father and my God, every mountain with that name in my life. Lord, right now, oh God, let the name be revealed now. Let them be able to pray right now. Every mighty without a name in my life, you have gone to hospital, they have done lab tests, they have gone to the laboratory, but they don't have a name. In the name of Jesus, Lord, let the name be revealed to your people. In the name of Jesus, Father, we thank you, oh God. Lord, we bless your name. Lord, we bless your name. We bless your name. Thank you, Father. For in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Father, we thank you this hour. Thank you, Father. Lord, everything that is called mountain, name or without name, Lord, this hour, we command them to be swallowed. Lord, we command them to be swallowed. We command them to be swallowed. Father, I pray for your son. This one that has injury on the right leg from where you're walking. Right now, I command him to come upon you in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, every arrow projected to cripple your son on that right leg. Right now, I command healing to come upon you. Let the mountain be swallowed right now. For in Jesus' mighty name, I pray.
Nothing, not even a mighty mountain, will be able to stand against you. That is the word of the Lord unto us. Now, add one more thing to what Pastor said. As we pray that the Lord will reveal the name of that mountain to us, the response we'll get will be shocking sometimes. Please don't be distracted by the answer you get. The work at hand is to speak to that mountain to be moved. So whatever gets revealed to you, step above that and speak to that mountain. Because the Lord has set it already that it will move when you speak to it. And so shall it be in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you so much for worshiping with us, for those that are watching from home, and for those that are in-house this morning. Shall we rise to our feet as we share the grace and close the service? And may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life, and we will dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. It is well with you. Mountains are moving for your sake in the mighty name of Jesus. Have a blessed week.